Now, given that I have a Punjabi mom and she wanted to have some insurance and
All moms. Hi, welcome back to Bani Abroad, and I'm here again with Ishan. So we are going to help you ease into your journey from India or from your home country to Canada with the cheapest flight and the best hotel. So Ishan recently traveled from India to Canada. Can you tell which month, date?
So I came here on 14th of March.
Okay, all right. So that's quite recent, and hopefully the flights will resume and you get to travel here soon. And we want to tell you how to book the cheapest flight, because Ishan was able to book one at
57,000 rupees.
That's great.
That's from Amritsar to Toronto, one stop at Delhi and then non-stop.
Yeah, that's a pretty good deal. So we'll be telling you how to book that. And the second part that we'll cover in this video is how to get the best hotel and what are the tips that you should keep in mind. A lot of students did face lots of problems with the hotel food or the customer service, and we don't want that to happen with you. So Shank, thank you for coming to the channel and helping the incoming students.
Happy to help.
So Shank, why don't we start with the flight first? So tell me, how were you able to manage to book this at 57,000?
So by the time that I got my PPR, I knew that in my mind, in about 14 or 15 days, I would be off to Canada. So I had to plan everything very quickly. So a general trend that I noticed, and what most of the people know, is if you book your flight 4 months before the departure date, it will be the cheapest, at least 4 months. The second trend, which is a new thing that I noticed, was flights are cheapest within 48 hours of departure as well.
Oh.
So that's both of the ways that you can swing. If you are planning to travel, let's say later, and you're pretty sure about it, you have your visa in your hand, go do it. 4 months, that's the time period. Or if you want to go get out of the country, do it within 48 hours. So that's what I did. In the last 10 days, I tracked my prices again consistently, and then what I noticed was the window shortened from 48 hours to 36 hours.
Oh.
So that's when the flight was cheapest. From Amritsar to Toronto, I was getting a flight at 50,000 rupees. Now that's within 36 hours.
Okay.
Why is that price amazing? Because the cheapest price from Delhi to Toronto is 50,000 rupees. Now, if you add the price from Amritsar to Delhi, plus you add the price of the extra baggage, that's 23, 23, 23 and
Right.
8 kgs. That's a lot of money. Now, given that I have a Punjabi mom and she wanted to have some insurance and
All moms.
so she was hell-bent on booking something early on, even if it costed 70,000-80,000 rupees. So I had to book something within 48 hours, and that cost me an extra 7,000. So I booked it for 57,000 rupees.
But that's pretty good as well.
Yeah.
So now you know the trick, you can save a lot of money. Apart from this, Ashan, would you like to give any other tips related to booking your ticket or anything else regarding the flight?
So a general misconception that I see in people is people are very paranoid on what they would be asked and how will they clear immigration, and you know, will it be stressful or will it be not? Would they be boarded back to India? So there are all these misconceptions, and I was going through that phase as well. I understand that part, but what I really want to tell you is that you are contributing to a $22 billion economy. That's what all the international students contribute to the Canadian economy every year. So 22 billion, that's a big number, and there's no reason they wouldn't want you here. So don't be stressed. It's pretty easy that they ask three or four basic questions, nothing major.
Just the people who are doing something illegal, of course, they would
I
have
mean,
that
yes,
in their
you should
mind.
be scared then.
But if you are going for a genuine course and coming here to make a life, then you don't need to worry.
Yeah, there are three basic questions. What's your name, just so that they verify with the passport? What course are you taking? What
Right.
college? What college are you going? So your classes started 2 months ago. You're studying online.
Oh, you
Why
would
do you
ask
want
this
to?
also. Okay.
Yeah, some people are asked this. Or you started classes started these many months ago. Why do you want to go now to Canada? You know, you can do all of that in India. So
Oh.
time zone, that's a very good answer. That's the only
Yeah.
answer. You know, time zone messes up with your circadian rhythm, it messes up the exams, you cannot study. That's the entire purpose you want to go to Canada, period. The second thing that I want to stress on is saving time. So imagine a plane filled with, let's say, 400 people. 200 or 300 of them are students, and they have to go to six or seven immigration counters. Imagine how much time will that take. So to save all of that 2 hours or 3 hours, what you have to do is you have to book your seats in front of the plane, right? So that's how things work. There is one exit in the front, During COVID time, that's how things work. The back exit, that doesn't work. They don't open it. So there's only one exit and it's first come, first serve. So only the people sitting at the front, they go first. So if you go first, you get your immigration done first.
At the Canadian airport, right?
This is at the Canadian airport at your port of entry. So I got my immigration done in 15 minutes. I got in, got out, got my study permit, got my baggage and I was out. So that was very quick. Some people wait for 2 hours, 3 hours. You know, why would you do that? If you're tired for 15 hours in a flight, if it's a connecting flight, even more than that. Right. If you're sitting for about 20 hours in a flight, why would you wait or stand an extra 3 hours or 2 hours just to get a study permit? So just book your flights in the front. If you are booking with Air India, you will get an option of selecting your seat or choosing your seat.
So
sirens are very loud here.
Yeah. Okay, now we can talk. So one tip here is that you book a direct flight and not a connecting flight, or if you have to book a connecting flight, then my advice is to have at least 3-4 hours gap in your connecting flight, because the study permit, that can take time. You don't know if you will get it within 15 minutes like he did, or would you have to wait for 2-3 hours. So it's always advisable that you keep a gap between those two flights so that you don't have to rebook the flight and then pay extra money for all of that.
I mean, if you're getting a direct flight under 60,000, go for it, you know. Do not compromise. Saving that extra money or the time is not worth it. You know, with the tips that I have given you, it's very easy to book a direct flight at a cheaper price. So go do it.
So thank you for sharing this information on flight tips. Now let's head on to the hotel section. So I've heard from a lot of people that there are a lot of complaints regarding the hotel service, the food, and I want that you do not go through that. So any tips on that?
So if you want to book the best hotel, go for Marriott or Hilton. But then again, these would be expensive. Yeah. What I did instead was I booked something in the middle. Don't go for the cheapest hotel. What I did was I went for Holiday Inn. That's on Dixon Road, right in front of the airport. It costed me close to $1,200. That's including tax. I booked that right after booking my air ticket and I booked it online. So it was quick, 10 minutes and I was done. I am in a group of 300 more students. One of the major complaints that I've seen in people is the customer service is bad, the food is bad, the food is not on time. Some people are getting their dinners at 11 p.m. Somebody is getting their breakfast at 11 a.m. So to avoid all of that, first tip, do not book the cheapest hotel. Four Points by Sheraton and all that, they are the cheapest. Do not go there. Second tip, do not book a hotel in Mississauga or Brampton. You land at Pearson, you choose a hotel in Toronto. The farther you go, the worse of the customer service you will get. So my hotel was Holiday Inn, Dixon Road, right in front of the airport. The staff was very nice. I got nice food. I actually stayed in the room with two beds, so the price was same. One bed was the same price, two bed was the same price, so I chose the two bed. I slept on one bed the one day and slept on the other day.
Okay. Now I remember one of my friends also came recently and he was mentioning that the hotel that he was staying at, they did not have a kitchen. So all he was getting was milk or some packaged stuff. So he had to spend his own money and he ordered from outside so that he could eat something good. So make sure, like Ishang mentioned, that don't go for the cheapest hotel because you have to eat through those 3 days, right? Any other tip that you might have?
So another thing I again got to know from a lot of students that their colleges were enforcing mandatory quarantines, again costing another $1,800. Now since we are Indians, we have most of our relatives here, you would rather stay with your relative for the next 14 or 11 days and save that cash. Colleges would say this is mandatory, this is that, but you know, that's all hoax. We all know that. Don't fall for it. It's like the mandatory dance class in school or the mandatory drawing class in school. That shit doesn't count.
I want to convey the intensity of how they were enforcing it. Could you tell? Did they say that you would have this repercussion if you
So my college warned about getting lower marks. They would suspend me or they would fail me.
So sitting back in India, you might feel really scared and you might book that, but it's okay.
Yeah, it's fine. As long as you paid the fees, it's all good. Come to Canada. There's also a general misconception that you have to stay for 3 days in the hotel. That's not true. If you get your negative report, which you will within the first 36 hours, you can leave and go to your relative's place or go to anywhere else.
Okay, now that's up to you. If you want to enjoy the hotel and you have paid the price, so why not live there? Or if you have your close relatives there and you can't wait to meet them, so of course you can leave on day 2 or day 3. That's totally fine. So now we are done with the tips. I hope that you do get a lot of value out of this and save a lot of money as well. Thank you, Shang, so much for sharing your experience with the audience.
Happy to help.
So I recorded a video with Shang earlier and I asked him about the 3 things that he found different in Canada in comparison to India. Now I want to ask you, you have been here for almost a month now.
Yep.
So what's one cool thing that you love about Canada?
Ice cream.
Oh.
So if you like ice cream, you love Canada's ice cream. What we had in India, I don't know what that was. That wasn't ice cream. So if you come here and, you know, even if you go to McDonald's, you try the McFlurry, that's $3 or something, $3.18 or something, you will love it. Ice cream is amazing. It's so creamy. It's so rich. Awesome.
Now, since Ishang is talking about food, I want to mention pizzas. So the pizzas here are yummy and authentic Italian style, Indian style, you will get a lot of variety. Also, by the way, I can give you free money on your first order through Skip the Dishes. That's a food delivery app here. And the link, the referral code is in the description below. And if you did like this video,
like and subscribe to the channel.
And don't forget to hit that bell icon as well. Until my next video, take care and stay happy. Bye.